Hello, family of God. This is Vicki and Chuck. Welcome to TLC. This is the day the Lord has made. We will rejoice and be glad in it. It's a beautiful day here in the Midwest. Thank you so much for joining us, you guys. We are blessed that you come and spend time with us here in this little corner of Father's Vineyard. If you're new, we welcome you in the name of our Savior. Thank you, Father, for this time and for each person who comes. I'm going to read to you guys today, and I'm in the book of Deuteronomy, chapter 7. Before I start, let me just say, for those of you, somebody out there is going to remember where it is in the messages that Father's given over the last, I think it was maybe 2 years ago. I can't remember where he talked about, it was the vision he gave me about the cattle. If someone remembers that, would you please email me or, because I need to know where it is and I don't have the time right now to go back and search, but one of the things I spoke about in there was about the cattle, and now it has begun. So you guys, please get in touch with me. I will post where that or what that link is when I hear from somebody. Thanks, y'all. Okay, chapter 7, the book of Deuteronomy. When the Lord your God brings you into the land that you are entering to take possession of it and clears away many nations before you, the Hittites, the Girgashites, the Amorites, the Canaanites, the Perizzites, the Hivites, and the Jebusites, seven nations more numerous and mightier than you. And when the Lord your God gives them over to you and you defeat them, then you must devote them to complete destruction. You shall make no covenant with them and show no mercy to them. You shall not intermarry with them, giving your daughters to their sons or taking their daughters for your sons, for they would turn away your sons from following me to serve other gods. Then the anger of the Lord would be kindled against you, and he would destroy you quickly. But thus shall you deal with them. You shall break down their altars and dash in pieces their pillars and chop down their asherim and burn their carved images with fire. Listen, you guys, that sounds harsh. Listen, listen, listen. It's not harsh at all. Verse 6. For you are a people holy to the Lord your God. The Lord your God has chosen you to be a people for his treasured possession out of all the peoples who are on the face of the earth. It was not because you were more in number than any other people that the Lord set his love on you and chose you. For you are the fewest of all peoples, but it is because the Lord loves you and is keeping the oath that he swore to your fathers that the Lord has brought you out with a mighty hand and redeemed you from the house of slavery, from the hand of Pharaoh, king of Egypt. Know, therefore, that the Lord your God is God, the faithful God who keeps covenant and steadfast love with those who love him and keep his commandments to a thousand generations and repays to their face those who hate him by destroying them. He will not be slack with one who hates him. He will repay him to his face. You shall therefore be careful to do the commandment and the statutes and rules that I command you today. And because you listen to these rules and keep and do them, the Lord your God will keep you with the covenant and the steadfast love that he swore to your fathers. He will love you, bless you, and multiply you. He will also bless the fruit of your womb and the fruit of your ground, your grain and your wine and your oil, the increase of your herds and the young of your flock in the land that he swore to your fathers to give you. You shall be blessed above all peoples. There shall not be male or female barren among you or among your livestock, and the Lord will take away from you all sickness, and none of the evil diseases of Egypt which you knew will he inflict on you, but he will lay them on all who hate you, and you shall consume all the peoples that the Lord your God will give over to you. Your eye shall not pity them, neither shall you serve their gods, for that would be a snare to you. If you say in your heart, these nations are greater than I, how can I dispossess them? You shall not be afraid of them, but you shall remember what the Lord your God did to Pharaoh and to all Egypt, the great trials that your eyes saw, the signs, the wonders, the mighty hand and the outstretched arm by which the Lord your God brought you out. So will the Lord your God do to all the peoples of whom you are afraid. Moreover, the Lord your God will send hornets among them until those who are left and hide themselves from you are destroyed. You shall not be in dread of them, for the Lord your God is in your midst, a great and awesome God. The Lord your God will clear away these nations before you little by little. You may not make an end of them at once, lest the wild beasts grow too numerous for you, but the Lord your God will give them over to you and throw them into great confusion until they are destroyed. And he will give their kings into your hand, and you shall make their name perish from under heaven. No one shall be able to stand against you until you have destroyed them. The carved images of their gods you shall burn with fire. You shall not covet the silver or the gold that is on them, or take it for yourselves, lest you be ensnared by it, for it is an abomination to the Lord your God. And you shall not bring an abominable thing into your house and become devoted to destruction like it. You shall utterly detest and abhor it, for it is devoted to destruction. Wow, 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 wow. That's not in there. I'm saying that. Wow, wow, wow. God doesn't want to be messed around with. You know, so many times people think, I failed so much and I seem to be so weak and Lord God, help. God promises that he will take care of those who belong to him. He did not promise that we wouldn't go through hard things. He actually told us that we would. He did not promise us. I'm going to say it again. He did not promise us that we would not go through hard things. He actually said, we will. But it's the trials by fire that you and I endure and refuse to turn away. It's the trials by fire that we go through and say, Father, yes, whatever it takes, do whatever you need to do in me. Whatever it is you want, Father. I am blessed beyond measure because you have touched me. You have called me by your Spirit. Thank you, Father. You guys, we have to be this way. Grateful, even in the midst of trials, because it's the purification process that we all need. Just reading chapter 7 of the book of Deuteronomy is enough to make anyone tremble, really, unless that one has a hard heart. God's instructions are very clear. We know Yeshua, Yahushua, Jesus, the Word, the Son of the living God, came to pay for our sins. Father is very serious about bringing everyone into the kingdom who will submit to him, who will come to him through that one and only way, the sacrifice of his Son. We could do things right all of our lives, get everything right, every single thing right, and just make one mistake, sin one time, and we would still be in need of a Savior. The lines are being drawn more clearly in the sand. There is no gray area. There is the right and there is the wrong. There is the good and there is the evil. Father, bless us all to choose to stand on your side. Every day, no matter how hard it may be, no matter what the trial may be, no matter what the temptation is, no matter what the fire, God, you're purifying your people. Open our eyes to see that's what's going on. Because sometimes, for many, it is too easy to fall into despair and discouragement and hopelessness and want to just give up. Lord God, help us get our eyes off of ourselves and come out of that poor me attitude and step into the true light, the light that shines, the light of our Savior, Jesus Christ. the living Word of God. Help us see that there is nothing, nothing we're going to have to sacrifice or go through in this life that we should ever, ever hold on to in exchange for our Savior and life with you in eternity. All glory and honor to you, Father. All glory and honor and praise to you, Almighty God. In the name of our Savior Jesus, the Christ, Yeshua, HaMashiach, we pray. Amen. Love you guys. Like I said, if somebody knows which message that was, because I cannot recall, but I just would like to be able to have somebody let me know, because I think somebody told me once before, but I can't. I think Catherine, did you tell me? Anyway, you guys, let me know, and I am going to post it in the comment section. I may upload it as an from the archives message again as well. Love you guys. Thank you for joining us again today. We will see you tomorrow, Lord willing. Bye for now.